Students, welcome back. So let's continue with the logical locks. In the previous video I explained what exactly the logical locks is. So in the clock synchronization you are going to learn about the physical clocks, logical clocks. Okay, so one of the technique that we algorithms that we applied in the logical locks is the lamport algorithms. So what is the main key idea of this lamport algorithm? In this video, I want to explain you what is exactly the lamport algorithm is. It means the introduction part of the lamport algorithms. In the next video, I'll explain the algorithm with an example. Okay. So now let's see what is this lamport algorithms and what is the main key idea of using this. The key idea of logical locks lamport algorithms is it is a process of exchange message. Okay, it's a process. Exchange message. The message must be sent before received. The one thing that you have to be remember that the message must be sent before received. So first you need to send the message, later you have to receive the reply. Means the message must be sent first. First this message has to be sent, later you have to receive the another one. Okay, so from that process or from a process or from another system. And send or receive used to order events and synchronize the logical clocks. So here the logical clocks mainly concentrate on the ordering of the events, not rather than the synchronizing the clocks. Whereas in the physical clocks, the first thing is we need to synchronize the clocks. But in logical clocks, to maintain the synchronization logical clocks, we used to concentrate on the order events. So first thing is we have to assign the sequence numbers to the messages because we are concentrating on the order event. So first process, suppose this is one system and here is another system and these are the another system. So this is a distributed environment. We are discussing about the distributed system. So many systems are participate in the network. We have to assign a number to the message. So first you need to assign a number to the message like one. Okay, so after that you need to send, after the completion of that you need to send the another message to the same system or to the another system. So that is the order of events. Whenever this one is acknowledged, completed, then only you need to send the another message. Here why we are assigning sequence numbers to the message, because to all cooperating process can agree an order of events, so that all the process can agree on order of events. And the logical versus physical clocks is on, completely on time of day. Here we have to assume no central time sources. There is no central time sources whereas in the physical clock. Here each system maintains its own local clock. Okay, so because it is a distributed system means every system is maintaining its own local clocks. No total ordering of events, that is no concept of happened when. So we don't bother about when it is happened. The thing is you have to maintain on order then ordering of an events, that's it. Okay, so don't bother up when it happened, at what time it is happened. Whereas in physical clock, at what time it is happened is very important. So for that we are to maintain the time synchronization to in the all systems, we are using different algorithms in the physical clock. But in the logical clock, you need to concentration on number of total ordering of events. There is no concept of happened when. So we have to think, and one more thing is you have to concentrate on happened before, not when. So lamport is always use the happened before notation. Okay, lamport uses the happened before notation. So what it means, so this is a notation, this notation you call it as a happened before notation. So here A determines a B. What it means, it means event A happened before event B. So first is the ordering here is this is for one and the ordering this is the two. So first one A is happened, next B is happened. After that if suppose C is happened means if you have to give the order number three. So the complete Lamport is depends upon the happened before notation. So A, this is a notation. Here the message being sent. A is sending the message and B is going to receive that message. Okay. So we are using the transitive property, that is A sends the message to B and the B sends the message to the C and again A can send the message to the C. Okay. So whenever A sends the message B, now A becomes free. Now B sends the message to the C. Okay. So already A is sent to the B. So A is free. No? So again A is going to send the message to the C. So this is, you have to remember that Lamport's use the happened before notation. That means event A happened before event B. So here the timing of A is less than the timing of B. Okay. Time of A is less than time of B. Because A is happened first. Next B is happened. Suppose A is happened at, let us take 4 p.m. And the B is happened is at 4:10 p.m. like that. So it should always less. It should always less and this should be more. Okay, so let's see some logical clocks and concurrency that is taking place in the Lamport algorithm. So let me explain this logical clocks and concurrency in the Lamport. First, we have to assign a clock value to each event. So not only the ordering, we know how to order and the clock. So assign a clock value to each event. So suppose if A Lamport's B here, that means A is happened before B. Okay, first it happens, next it happens. So then clock of A should less than the clock of B. So whatever I said now, since time cannot run backward, remember that in the logical clocks, the time cannot run backwards. So at this point, you have to be remember that the time cannot run backward. If A and B occurs on different process, so let us take if these A and B, these are all the two events. These two events occur on different process. So A is occur in one system and the B is occur in the another system. Or in the same systems, different processes that do not exchange message. So suppose these two are not exchanging messages. So then neither A Lamport B nor B Lamport B are true. So both are not true because if there is no network, then there is no concept of synchronization, then there is no concept of checking the logical clocks and the physical clocks because every system is independent. It means whatever the system that are participating in this environment are independent. If they are independent, if there is no connection between them, there is then no need to bother about that which event comes and which event is coming next. So these events you call it as a concurrent. If they are not participating in the network and they are not exchanging the messages, then those events we call it as a concurrent. So finally, at Lamport instead of synchronizing clock, event ordering can be used. Let me tell you a simple example that is the event counting, how you are going to count the event. So if you know these example, then you can easily implement the Lamport algorithm. So event counting example. So let us take three systems P0, P1, P2. So or else P1, P2, P3. I have taken P1, P2, P3. So I taken three systems P1, P2, P3. And here the events that are participating in each process is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. Okay. So these are all the events that are participating in the systems. Here the local events counters on each system and system occasionally communicate. So here the local events are counters on each system. Means first A happens, next B happens, next C happens, next D, next E, like that. So A determines B and the B determines C, like that. So occasionally they are communicated. So here just you can see E is communicated to H event which is present on process 2 and F is communicated with the K event which is present on the process system P3. So like that, system is occasionally communicated. So now let's see, is this process is having the good ordering or bad ordering. So let's take if A and B are the events in the same process. Suppose if A and B are in the same process and A occurs before B, here A is occurring before B, then A Lamport B is true. So, and the same way here, because the ordering, did you observe the orderings here? 1, 2, this is the event ordering. First A is coming, next to B, next to C, D, E, F. Okay, so in this process, the ordering is, so the ordering has to be given to the events that are participating in the same process. So here in the process P2 in the system, in the system P2, the process is, the events are G, H, I. So you have to give the ordering 1, 2, 3. So in the process, in the system P3, two events are participating, J and K. You have to order as 1, 2. Okay, so these ordering is independent of these ordering. So each system is having their own ordering of the process, because these two processes are participating. Here three processes are participating, and here six processes are participating. Now let's see. I'm saying that E Lamport H is bad ordering, F Lamport K is a bad ordering. Why I'm saying that E determines H is bad ordering and F determine K is bad ordering. Let's see here. So E determines H. So the communication is establishing like this. So here the order of E is, what is the time of E? The time of E is 5. And the time of the event H is equal to 2. The order of the time. Here the 2. But according to our Lamport algorithm, A determines B means time of A is less than time of B. So this is true. So here the time of E is not less than, okay, so it is not less than time of F. Why it is not less than? Because time of E is a 5. Okay, so the 5 is less than 2. Is it correct? Is 5 is less than 2, is it correct? No, it is not correct. So I am saying that this is a bad ordering, because 5 is always greater than or equal to 2, not, it is not less than 2. So this is a bad order. Again here, see here, time of F is 6 and time of K is 2. Is 6 is less than 2? No, 6 is greater than 2. Okay, so that's why this is also bad ordering. And the remaining all is okay. So here, see here, time of the sender has to be less and the receiver has to be more. The time of sender is less and the receiver has to be more. Here the time of G is 1. Order of the G is 1 and the order of D is 4. Is 1 is less than 4? Yes. So this is correct. And here also, the order of J is 1 and the order of the sender is 1 and the receiver is 3. So 1 is less than 3. This is also correct. So only the thing is, these two events are not correct. So this is how you have to be find out the logical clocks by using the Lamport algorithm. So this technique, you call it as a Lamport algorithm. So in the next video, I'll explain the Lamport algorithm with an example. Thank you.